I worked on the dock here where they loaded barges and they'd bring boxcars with groceries, and we'd have little hand carts with iron wheels haul them in to the very big warehouses and sort them to each place they're going to. And then as the time passed, we got better hand carts that had rubber wheels, and then they came out with little forklifts with iron wheels at first, and then they got rubber wheeled ones. And I started there, and I learned how to run the forklift, and then I got on a crane, load the big, then they called pallet loads, put them on the barges. And
so everything's getting bigger and bigger as time goes on, the machinery.
And there was I've got a picture. I know that it showed right this side of the railroad bridge down there. They had five steamboats that they pulled up in the fall time for the winter, and there was all five steamboats sitting together there and some barges. I went and was there was hardly no work in that on the dock until the boss down there transferred me to one of them steamboats. And as a fireman, you just sit there, and with two valves they had, when I got on there, they had switched it from wood boilers to oil.
Oil.
And you just had two valves there to regulate this pressure to run the paddle wheel. Hmm. I know they'd ship coal down the river.
Okay.
You'd go to work, sign the contracts, and they'd just give you great big bundles of burlap bags, and you had to get in that railroad car and fill the sacks, pile them up, and then they'd load them on the barges and
take them down.
That was just before the, I think I was after the wood and then the coal and then the oil.
So we're here at 4 p.m. on this date, October 15th, 1947. At 4 p.m., do you remember about this event?
Well, I remember I was living with a guy. He had an old cabin next street, and I was the only one in the house there, home then, and I remember the house started shaking, and there was a back door that come on the back of the house, and then a kind of a shed. And a couple of steps you had to go down into the shed from the back house. I remember I shaked the bed. I just tried to run.
Tried to get out of the house?
Yeah, get out of the house, and I got to the outdoor to out of the shed, and I shoulder hit the wall with the edge of the doorway, and I just fell down there. I just rolled away from the house. That's all I remember of it.
So you remember, but you remember, you know, you felt a lot of earthquakes, but these ones were really big. So the fact that you couldn't get yourself through the door, you remember basically trying to walk through, and the door basically moved into
your... Well, I was trying to get out fast as I could.
Danny said you guys have a cabin up on the Kantishna, is that right?
I was at the cabin.
Oh, you were On the Kantishna?
Yeah, and Mom told me to get something out of the high cache. So I climbed the ladder and I went in there, and then I started shaking, and then she went to the door and hollered to get out, but how can I go down the stairway? I'm rocking.
You were in the cache at a kind of unfortunate time.
She had us on the stilts.
That when it was over, even the ice was cracked.
So you're up in the cache. There must be snow, right? The permanent snow is here for the winter.
I wasn't.
And?
Yeah, I can't get out that little door.
So what else, after you come down, is there any other evidence that this earthquake had happened?
I went right in the house.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So do you remember?
But my mom, she was so excited, you know. So they're screaming in there and trying to get me out.
Yes.
And freeze up, then we come in the wintertime with dogs.
Okay, so you had dogs, so are you cutting kind of wet, east, or you cut across the flats, you're not using the river, or would the dog teams take...
They'd come across the flats and...
Straight across.
She'd walk all the way.
Why would you walk?
Marshall!
She was the oldest child in the family, and she did the...
No trail.
She snowshoed ahead of the dog team after they left her.
So you were living out there.
We come in for holidays and things like that.
I see. So you were actually living out on the Kantishna. Mm-hmm.
I was raised out there.
So Nenana was sort of... Nenana would be like the big city in a way.
Yeah, I don't know. There must have been between 3,000 to 5,000 people when they... Railroad was being built.
Okay, and your birthday?
Mine is July 16th,
1929. Okay, 29. So in fact, you felt the 1937 earthquake too.
Yeah.
But that might have been...
That and I was standing by across the creek there and hiding on the willow. Of course I was rocking.
So it turns out you were born when... Now this is going to be an interesting connection. On the day of your 21st birthday, which would be 1947, October 15th...
I was thinking about that.
You hit a magnitude 7.2 earthquake, the biggest earthquake. So you must have some memory. If you can remember your 21st birthday, you must know what you were up to when that hit.
I was up on top of the roof, working on a house.
This is the toll of honor?
Toll of honor. We just got through building the house there. And then what a surprise I got. Earthquake.
How's it, so you're at this...
I was standing up, fixing up a roof up on top, insulated with moss. My mother was down there. Had a little bucket and filled the bucket up, and I pulled it up with rope, laying the moss on top, insulation.
So what happened? Did you hang out up there?
When that earthquake hit, I was down on the edge of the building there, and I had to move up. I was flat on my back. I watched all the trees there flopping around there. Never think of any one of them will break down.
Wow, yeah.
And my mother was out in the front there, and she'd stand there. I don't know where my sister was, inside or outside. Well, my mom felt it before, way back in 1918, when she was about 13 years old. She said, that's the biggest earthquake they ever seen.
Really?
Wherever that earthquake was, they were manly husbands. She says, you could see the ashes coming down.
Oh, that's, could that be a volcanic eruption?
Yeah.
Okay, that could, I wonder if that's Valley of, that would have been, Katmai, I think. Katmai was the biggest eruption of, one of the biggest eruptions of in the world for the last 100 years.
Yeah.
Oh, that's really neat. So she, Okay, that would have been scary. So they would have seen the ash coming, but no earthquake probably. Just
yeah, they seen the ash.
Okay.
Well, they know it was earthquake.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know much about that event, but I can imagine you could hear. You probably could hear it, but I don't know. It was major. Blew the volcano out, but.
Well, she told me all about it. Yeah.
So what did she describe that as?
She was down
in
Manly Hot Spring. Okay. Yeah. That's where they had to camp my mom's dad and them. That's where she was raised.
And so, what does she describe as seeing or hearing or smelling? What?
Well, she can hear it, I guess, coming. But, and she said, just ash just all over coming down.
Falling down.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow.
You know, they got these tents up, you know, a tent, and it's white and it's just black from the ashes.
That's interesting. Yeah, I don't know what.
I know.
See, that would be scary. See, I wonder just because if you don't know anything about earthquakes and your parents or grandparents have never felt an earthquake, it might seem scary. But if it's just a part of life, every 10 years there's an earthquake, maybe nobody's surprised or alarmed.
Yeah, this happened in the summertime, I guess. Yeah.
Okay. What is the, how would you describe the relationship between Nenana and Minto back in this sort of 30s, 40s, 50s, up until when they relocated?
Well, they were just like one whole village, you know, family. Yeah. I mean, people.
So they're kind of concentrated in Minto, concentrated in Nenana.
Nenana, yeah. They feel like they're all one family.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's no...
They come back and forth and visit, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oops.
And some of them that live here, was born here, they moved to Minto, they get married down there.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing here. Yeah.
So it's more of just two different places where people have congregated or settled, but there's no real difference other than that.
Yeah.
Okay.